Congressman Troy Carter calls the new FEMA flood insurance rates outrageous.
Carter says he pressed the head of Homeland Security, which oversees FEMA, to find out how FEMA determined which people would have to pay more. WGNO's LBJ is here with more on that. LBJ.
Yeah, Susie and Kurt, congressional hearings happen all the time, but this one was pretty significant to the folks that live in this area because we've all suffered sticker shock at the rates of the National Flood Insurance Program. Up till now, we've been told that the risk rating 2.0 system was permanent. And while FEMA has not made public how the rating system worked, during the hearing, the head of Homeland Security admitted that the system needs to be reviewed and that admission hopefully opens the doors for lower rates. We spoke with Congressman Carter earlier today about how this could impact people in our state and elsewhere as well.
While this is something that is unique in hurting my district in Louisiana, it's not unique to the rest of the country because there are a lot of other southern states who are similarly situated where they're seeing rates of 100, 120, 130% increase. Mm-hmm. Those are deal breakers. Mm-hmm. This is not a done deal. There's still revisions and reviews to happen, and I think it's important that the people of Louisiana know that we're fighting to make sure that it's not a done deal.
Carter also says that the state's congressional delegation is simultaneously hoping to propose legislation that will alleviate the strain on homeowners struggling to pay the high flood insurance rates. Now, FEMA falls under the umbrella of Homeland Security, so having a dialogue with the secretary and having him understand the issues of the residents is the farthest we've come so far in trying to get some results on the high rates. Let's all hope we can get somewhere on this for sure.
Yeah, because next year they just go up again.
They'll just go up another 130%, which we can't handle, okay?
Thank you, OBJ.